Centre want the Civil Aviation Authority to recover 2.1 billion Uganda shillings overpayment to Sayani Brothers, the contractors, for the remodification of Entebbe Airport. MPs on the Committee on Commissions, Statutory Authorities and State Enterprises, or COSASE, also quizzed CAA officials led by Fred Bamwesigye, the Director General, on employing relatives within the authority. Our reporter was there and has more.
According to the Auditor General's report for financial year ended June 2019, the contractor for the modification of the passenger terminal building at Entebbe International Airport, Sayani Brothers and Company Uganda Limited, was overpaid by 2.1 billion shillings, as evidenced in the interim payment certificates identified by the members of parliament.
We have yet to come to terms with your justification for this overpayment, and that's why you remember previously we were insisting and saying, just like the Auditor General recommended, this money gets recovered because you paid the contractor more than they worked for according to the schedule, according to what was stipulated. And as far as the AG is concerned, Auditor General, and ourselves too, there's been no evidence yet to justify.
It was seen fit during that meeting to say, please go back and the management and harmonize. Honorable Chair, I am requesting that we do that harmonizing, and then we really get a true picture of that.
They are presumed to be actual, and as Parliament and as COSASE, we must stand with the position of the Auditor General. As it is, if there are any other efforts to reconcile, that is done, that is secondary. Ordinarily, they would have had the harmonization even before. And secondly, there is no law that requires that the line entity must agree with the decision of the Auditor General.
Now, the committee led by Chairperson Joel Senyonyi wants this money recovered, since CAA has failed to reconcile the audit query with the Auditor General.
What was the purpose of the overpayment? I mean, even the Auditor General is saying, no, there's an issue here. So we are moving to make sure that money is recovered, because if work was done for a particular amount, why are you paying them more than they did? Well, what is the understanding there?
The authority has also, for the third time, failed to explain the 6.4 billion shillings variation in architectural designs for the expansion of Entebbe International Airport, also worked on by Sayani Brothers. The contract rose from 42 to 49 billion shillings. The authority has also failed to provide documents to justify the variation of the contract.
For a contract to be varied upwards, in this case to the tune of 6.4 billion shillings, that let's now add this cost. Who gets to approve this? Who gets to decide that now let's ask for more money? That's what it means. What is the justification for this extra request, and where is it going?
I was wondering and curious to know, at what stage was the board involved in these matters, because these are big variations and changes, and if the board was involved, could you kindly give us evidence that you didn't just go on your own with your contracts committee?
Management was involved, board was involved before the contracts committee came in. We had a bit of issues with the secretariat and really printing this document.
The committee also queried the Civil Aviation Authority Director General for reportedly employing relatives. MP Joel Senyonyi explained that he got information from a whistleblower indicating that several officers at the authority, including Ronald Twesije, who was present, are relatives of the CAA Director General, Fred Bamwesigye.
No one can say that your relatives can't be qualified to get jobs or that kind of thing. But there were issues with the manner, and again, when there are many, it raises questions for a public entity. And I want to read to you these names that were provided, and you let me know if you know them, and if it is actually true they are your relatives, and good enough you are on oath.
I can tell you that without any doubt that this whistleblowing was aimed at this job which I got 4 days ago. 6 days ago. And I can tell you without a shadow of doubt
that was intended maybe to make you do a ruling or something like that to say this process must stop. And that's the purpose of that drawing.
The committee told CAA officials to come with a list of the mentioned officers and how they were employed.
We want to get to the bottom of this, and that's why we've asked them for documents of the staff members that they have, so that we are certain who was hired and how. And we're not saying somebody's relative cannot work in the same company as them, but if it is true that there are many relatives of the Director General, how were they hired? You know, are there no others that were qualifying? Why must it just be them? So these are issues that we are digging up on.
Report by Fred Kajobi for the news at Parliament.